If you have transactions that recur on a regular schedule, you can program QuickBooks to record them for you. Let's do this by opening the gear icon, and then under Lists, choosing Recurring Transactions. To enter a new recurring transaction, select New. Now QuickBooks allows us to choose the type of transaction that we want to enter as a recurring transaction. Note that nearly any type of transaction can be made into a recurring transaction. We have a customer that we invoice monthly, and we want QuickBooks to take over the invoicing task for that customer. So select Invoice, and then OK. This monthly invoice is for Chad Kunert. In the name of this invoice will be Chad's Monthly Gardening Invoice. This is a scheduled recurring transaction, but you can also create reminders and unscheduled recurring transactions from this list. Right here, you can choose for QuickBooks to create the transaction a couple of days in advance of the actual programmed interval. This is usually useful for checks and other transactions that you need to send through the mail. That's not the case with us, so we'll leave this field blank. QuickBooks already has information about our customer's email address and billing address, so there's nothing for us to enter there. Right here, we can also enter any additional options like automatically sending emails whenever the invoice is generated, printing later, or including unbilled charges. We're just going to make sure that this is emailed out to our customer. And if you're using QuickBooks Online Payments, you can also give them the ability to pay with credit card or free bank transfer. Here in the middle of the screen, you can choose the interval that this transaction will be created. QuickBooks supports daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly intervals. And for each one of these intervals, you can also have QuickBooks skip a number of days, weeks, months, or years whenever you're entering it. We're going to have QuickBooks create this transaction for us monthly on the first of every 1 month. It's important to note that what we're entering right now is not an actual invoice. Instead, what we're doing is telling QuickBooks to start entering an invoice for us on a set date, which is the start date, and then to create the transaction again whenever this interval occurs. For us, we want QuickBooks to start creating this transaction for us on 03/01/2018, which is the start of next month. You can also tell QuickBooks to stop entering this transaction by a certain day or after a number of occurrences. We're going to say that Chad has signed up for this service for 12 months. Now let's scroll down a bit. We have to tell QuickBooks what is going to be included on the invoice. Chad has signed up for gardening services, so we'll select that from our products and services list, and he's contracted us for 5 hours worth of gardening services every month. Now let's save the template. QuickBooks will now start generating this invoice for us on the 1st of March of this year. It will automatically send it out to Chad through email, and we don't have to enter this transaction by hand anymore. If at any time this agreement changes and we need to change the invoice that we've programmed into QuickBooks, just choose Edit here, and you can also duplicate, pause, skip next date, or delete this recurring transaction from this list. Use recurring transactions to reduce your data entry workload.